set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Hawaii is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Northern Illinois' coaching staff, the fans, I think everybody's been waiting to see this kid play, and here he is.
He's a star quarterback. He seems to bring everything to the table. The crowd, I think, senses he's ready to have a big day. And when your star quarterback feels good playing at home, and he gets off to a good start, some big things can happen for this offense.
And they make the stop at the 33. Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards. Brought down at the 29-yard line.
The defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
From their own 29-yard line. It's third down. Now he's scrambling. He's taken down at about the 31. They'll be short of the first down after that unsuccessful running play.
Nice job here by the defense of holding firm and forcing a fourth down.
He makes it out to about the 41-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Here they come. He's at midfield. Tackle made at the 47-yard line. They'll get the first down.
He made the correct decision to tuck it and go.
From the 47-yard line, first down. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Just gets rid of it. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From the 42-yard line, third down. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Number 39 was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up fourth and 5.
Right now he wants to get this kick away and change field position. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. They try to run up the middle, but met in the backfield. From their own 18-yard line, it's second down. The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Now he tries to buy some time. Slides down to the ground.
That makes it 3rd and 7.
He scrambles. And down he goes at the 32-yard line. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
This receiving corps runs some great routes, and that last play was an example of that. As a defender, it can be tough to match up sometimes.
at the 41. And that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
And he's tackled at the 29. Bring him down around the 26-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive. They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. And he's taken down around the 24-yard line. To him before he could get back to the line. That brings us to fourth and 7. So it's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long attempt. Northern Illinois is looking to go up by 3. The kick is away. It's long enough. And he nails the long field goal.
That one looked like cake for this kid. Chalk up 3 points for the offense.
3-0, Northern Illinois. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 26-yard line. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice gain.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. He's going to try and scramble. Tackled at about the 45. He's on the run, and they make the stop at the 47. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Makes it to the 37. Him hard at the 25-yard line. There are 3 quarters remaining. Northern Illinois has got a 3-point lead. That makes it first and 10. Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, 5 wide receivers. His man can't tack on any yardage. That's a gain of 7 on the play. That'll bring up second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. And off up the middle, and he's stuffed. Here's the eighth play of the series. Fires it out. Brought down at the 18. It's fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. Hawaii can tie it up here with this kick. The kick is up, and he's got it. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 26. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Throws it in a hurry. He's taken down around the 32-yard line. Intercepted. They're really fortunate that wasn't intercepted.
Not a very smart decision by the quarterback. He had no shot at completing it.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Mike 56.
Scrambling around. Tackle made at the 41-yard line. At the 46-yard line. Fires out to his receiver. He's tackled at the 34. On the ground with a tailback. Makes it out to maybe the 13-yard line. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. And he's tackled right away. Five wide. He's scrambling, and he can't get away from the pressure. Here's the 11th play of the drive. He's tackled at about the 3 yard line. He's got the corner. Touchdown, Huskies.
Perfect call under these circumstances, confusing them with the option and then getting the football into the hands of the running back.
splits the uprights with the extra point. It was a 12-play, 74-yard drive, and they get it in for seven. So our score, 10-3. They line up to kick this one away. Taken from the 3-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. 5 yards.
Not a bad play. They gain 5 yards out of it, and they keep moving the defense back.
From their own 25-yard line. Second down. Gets to that quickly. They'll bring him down around the 34-yard line. Taken down at the 43-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards.
It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Catches it, and he's looking for more. Knocked out of bounds at midfield. They get about 7 yards on the pass and pick up a first down.
And still, this gunslinger hasn't missed a receiver yet on this drive.
Slings it out there. Tight end's got another one. Loose football. Recovered by the offense.
You expect your tight ends to be pretty sure-handed. I'm sure they weren't expecting him to cough up the ball like that.
From the 33-yard line, it's first down. So the question here is whether or not his knee hit the ground before the ball came out.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So the booth and the referee agree the runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
He steps out at the 30-yard line.
That's a gain of 4 on that. That makes it second and 6.
It's second down, 6 to go. Ball on the 30. Gets it. He's in space. Tackle around the 25-yard line.
Did you see how he looked that ball into his hands? That's how you catch a football.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. He's got it with room to run. He goes out of bounds. Right around the 22-yard line.
First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 22-yard line. Now he's scrambling. He's wrapped up for the sack.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. And that's what happened there.
He launches one for the end zone.
It can be tough making a play on the ball sometimes, but that's probably a pick he should have made.
And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Deep ball, laying it out there. They'll call on the field goal unit here. Kicks away, and it's good. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The offense now will take the field, and they hope to have the same success they had on their last drive.
So much of the passing game is about the time between the quarterback and his wide receivers. And right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Fires out to his wideout. And they make the stop at the 41. The Huskies are going to call their second timeout. Northern Illinois holds a 4-point lead. He goes downtown. It's caught. Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves him with a first and goal. Well, we're headed to halftime now, and we're seeing two defenses that don't want to give an inch. Northern Illinois up by 4.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnovers. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game, but you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002, in a certain formation where it's Tucson open stud, and they got 3 receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
That's it for us here in the studio. What are you going to do in the second half of the games going on?
Yeah, I'm
going
to kick back and watch all these monitors.
We'll keep you up to date on everything going on around the country right now. Time for the second half with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately. Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 20. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. He's to the 40. Across midfield. Brought down at the 45-yard line. And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Call it a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and 4.
Man left. Four down. Hey, check Mike 35.
Quick strike to the receiver. He's hit and taken down.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 24-yard line, first down.
Three down.
Quick throw to the tight end. He's knocked out of bounds at the 18-yard line. And he tackles him hard at the 19-yard line. From the 19-yard line, it's third down. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. He's taken down right around the 18-yard line. He gets it up, and it's through the uprights. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. At the 30. The 50. He's pushed out of bounds at the 34-yard line. Flag on the play. Let's see what it is.
Clipping. Receiving team.
Clipping is the call, and now they'll have to find a way to make up those yards right here. They're ready to begin another drive. Northern Illinois with a one-point lead. He fights forward to about the 30. He scrambled, and he's going to be sacked.
It's a big-time effort sack by the defensive end. I want to also give some credit to the coverage downfield. The end never gave up on the play, but because the quarterback didn't have anywhere to go with the football, it gave the defensive end enough time to eventually chase the quarterback down for that sack.
From their own 27-yard line, third down.
Mike 56.
He gets out to about the 28-yard line. He makes it to the 38-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Fires it out. Very good tackle in space. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He makes his way to about the 45. Quick throw. Tackle made at the 30. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 30-yard line. Scrambling around. They bring him down.
That makes it
It's second and 10.
Ball on the 30.
So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. He's going to try and scramble. And down he goes. Right around the 30. And he's level at the 38-yard line.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
Fourth and long here after the sack. The punter is going to try to pin him deep in their own territory with a good punt here. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Hawaii's not going to back down from anybody, Herbie. I guess at least not today.
No, not today. They played with a chip on their shoulder. They've stood toe-to-toe with the big boys, and I don't think they're finished yet.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Northern Illinois is up one. So with one quarter remaining, the Huskies lead 10-9. Well, this final few minutes is going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. Offense lines up in a five wide set, and a defense anticipating pass here.
He's tackled
around the 22-yard line. Didn't stop the pass, but they stopped him short of the sticks.
And that's the important thing here. Allow him to make the catch, but make sure you tackle him before he gets to the first down marker.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt.
Tackle made at the 45.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter.
That's a great tackle at the 47-yard line.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. And a quick throw. And he's tackled around the 27-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 27-yard line, first down. They'll bring him down at the 14.
Taken down
around the 6-yard line.
Gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and 2.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
Gets to about the 5-yard line.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. Touchdown, and now they're in front.
great job and some tough running right there. When you get close to the end zone, things get very tight, and it's tough to maneuver.
Well, they're going to try for the two-point conversion. He's on the run. And he's in for two. So under 3 minutes to go in the fourth quarter, and the score is 17-10, Hawaii. Hawaii is ready to kick it away. He'll return it from the three. Brought down at the 23-yard line. The Huskies have played poorly all day long. That really doesn't matter right now.
They've played sloppy. They're not going to be happy when they go back and look at the film on Monday. But with all that being said, they still have a chance to win this game. And at the end of the day, that's all that matters, is trying to get that W.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. Gets out to around the 32. He'll get the call again. Makes it out to about the 40. Just under two to go in the game. Now he tries to buy some time. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. Slides down. The middle to his tailback. Tackle at the 42. From the 42-yard line, second down. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And they make the stop at the 31-yard line. To his halfback again, and he hits him hard at the 19.
Gain 3 yards.
Check number six. Check.
That'll make it second and seven.
Let's go, G. Get off the field. Here we go. Bring it, bring it, bring it, bring it.
Gets it out quickly, and he shoved out of bounds at about the 9-yard line.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
Quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So the call on the field stands. Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he converts the extra point. Just under a minute left in the fourth quarter, and this game hasn't failed to disappoint. The score is tied up at 17. Northern Illinois kicked this one off. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't?
We have less than a minute to go. Now he's scrambling. Runs with it, and he's got room. Tackle made at the 48. Defender had it and then dropped it.
Smart, heady play by that defender. That was solid, fundamental pass defense.
From their own 48-yard line. Second down. He gets rid of this one. Throw to the tight end. He's at the 40. Brought down around the 36-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 36.
I really like going to the tight end here on third down. It's not even about the defense not expecting it, because I think they did. It's about mismatches. He's probably bigger and stronger than the guy who's trying to cover it.
Quick strike to the receiver. And down he goes. Right around the 28-yard line. The Warriors use their second timeout. First down. He's taken down at about the 21. Looks left, finding his tailback. He's tackled
around the 11-yard line. The Warriors using their third and last timeout.
Here's the eighth play of the series. The kick is up. Yes, he made it, and this one is over. And that gives them the lead.
I know that I call kickers head cases, but this kid isn't one. It's like he doesn't even feel the pressure.
A great game here today in a tight one. 2017, Hawaii. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.